The Battle of Hoth was a devastating defeat for the Rebel Alliance, and reminded the galaxy of the true might of the Galactic Empire. I'm Knight One, and today we will be discussing the Battle of Hoth, from the Imperial discovery of the Rebel base to the frantic evacuation that cost the Rebellion greatly. Following the Rebel evacuation of their base at Yavin, the Empire began searching the galaxy for their new base. The Empire began deploying a series of probe droids to expand their search in the Outer Rim. One eventually discovered the Alliance's new base on the planet of Hoth. Luke Skywalker initially noticed the probe droid crash, but before he could investigate it, he was attacked by a Wampa, which required him to be rescued. Han Solo and Chewbacca would later go on to investigate what Luke had initially seen, but were attacked by the probe as they got near it. Han and the rest of the Rebels quickly deduced that the Empire would soon arrive and that they needed to evacuate Echo Base as soon as possible. Meanwhile, aboard the Super Star Destroyer the Executor, Admiral Ozzel had initially dismissed the probe droid's findings, but Darth Vader himself insisted that the Rebels were in fact on Hoth and that the fleet should be dispatched immediately. With the Empire fast approaching, Leia briefed her forces on the evacuation plan. Each transport would launch with the support of two X-Wings and the planetary ion cannon in order to take out any Star Destroyers in their path. Rebel ground forces would assemble outside in order to defend the base from any kind of Imperial ground invasion. Luke Skywalker and Rogue Squadron would also stay behind to fly a group of airspeeders and provide cover for the ground forces. With their plan in place, the Rebellion braced for the arrival of the Empire.
Vader, the fleet has moved out of light speed and we're preparing to...
You have failed me for the last time, Admiral. Captain Piet.
Yes, my lord.
Make ready to land our troops beyond their energy field, then deploy the fleet so that nothing gets off the system. You are in command now, Admiral Piet.
Thank you, Lord Vader.
When Darth Vader's fleet arrived at Hoth, he discovered that the Rebels were already alerted to their presence, and raised a deflector shield to protect them from any kind of bombardment. Admiral Ozzel had pulled the fleet out of lightspeed too close to the system against Darth Vader's orders. Vader, angered by his decision, force-choked Ozzel to death for his poor judgment and promoted Captain Piet to the rank of Admiral, leaving him in charge of the invasion. Piet would then send General Maximilian Veers down to the planet to attack Echo Base with a direct AT-AT assault. On the ground, Rebel forces would attempt to hold back the approaching walkers from within their trench lines. However, they would quickly find out just how ineffective their defense turrets would be against the walking behemoths of the Empire. Luke Skywalker and the rest of Rogue Squadron would quickly engage the AT-ATs, but they too found that their weapons simply were not strong enough to pierce the walkers' heavy armor. Thinking quickly, Luke ordered his squad to use the airspeeder's tow cables against the legs of the walkers in an attempt to trip them over and knock them down. Rogue 3, Wedge, was the first to successfully take one out, and others would quickly follow suit. The battle would unfortunately take a turn for the worse as several speeders, including Luke himself, would be shot down. Luke was able to escape his crash and single-handedly take out a walker using a thermal detonator. Despite the valiant efforts of the defenders, they were ultimately overwhelmed by the Imperial advance. With the majority of their defenses destroyed, Leia ordered all remaining forces to evacuate before the Empire could overwhelm them completely. Rebel forces in the trench lines began their retreat towards the base while under heavy fire from the advancing walkers. After getting into firing range, General Veers fired on the shield generator, destroying it and allowing Darth Vader and his forces to land. Vader and his troops quickly stormed Echo Base, eliminating any remaining rebels inside. Meanwhile, Han, Chewie, Leia, 3PO, and R2 were attempting to escape on board the Millennium Falcon. The Falcon was in a sad state, and as such would not start despite the Imperials quickly closing in. Just before Vader got to them, however, they were able to just barely escape. With the majority of the base evacuated, Luke linked up with one of the last evacuation groups, boarded an X-Wing, and helped escort the remaining transport off the world before breaking off to go to the Dagobah system. The destruction of Echo Base was a devastating blow to the Rebellion. With most of Rebel Command scattered, the Rebellion would struggle to regroup for several weeks following the Battle of Hoth. The Empire would continue to pursue the remaining Rebel forces, but would fail to capture their leadership. Ultimately, the Rebel Alliance, although being forced to abandon a large amount of resources during their hasty evacuation, a large amount of their personnel were able to escape, especially the Rebel leadership, whose destruction would be critical to the Imperial efforts to defeat the Rebellion. Despite this defeat, the Rebel Alliance would go on to engage the Empire in an all-or-nothing assault on the second Death Star just a few months later, resulting in the downfall of the Galactic Empire. I'm Knight One, and that was the Battle of Hoth.